Yeah, about to call it a day. I'm running into a couple of these. I'm going to try and see if I can repair them. They're SATA DVD-ROMs or burners. I used to repair these back in the day when they were actually pretty expensive still. They used to call me CD-ROM Dave because they used probably the only one that used to record the repair these. So, a few things to look for when you're repairing them. First, before you go hog wild and trying to replace the assembly inside of them, simply just see how filthy the lens are for starters, including the lens. Clean the lens up and then you're good to go. This one's not very old. Well, actually, it's need a microphone glass here. This one came out in 2009. Yeah, okay, it's old, but most of the time, they don't get their full usage. They just get full of dirt and stop working. So, we take this off. Pop that up. See, it's got some dirt in it. That's going to affect its performance right there. And turn it over. And you should be able to tip the top off. If not, you can do this. You can poke something in that little hole and pop the door open, which I have something here. Little drill screwdriver here. Just poke it like that. What that does, pokes that open. Pull the door off like that. And you can get the front off by poking these little pins on the side. The front comes off, and that's that. And then the rest you just dump right out. There we go. See, it's got a lot of dust in it. So you're going to want to check the lens here. I'll just use a loop. Just have a quick look at it. Okay, it doesn't look too bad. I'm just going to brush it all out, clean the lens, and then we'll test it. If it still doesn't work, then it's the actual laser itself, and it won't be worth fixing it. Well, I mean, if you had parts from another one, sure, but I don't think it's worth it. Okay, we're just quickly putting it back together. I can't run it without the base on it because the chips sometimes will overheat right away. And there's heat pads underneath all the chips that draw the heat away from the ICs and the casing acts as a heat sink. And you can damage it, so it doesn't hurt to just throw it back together and test it. Oh! Sorry about that. Okay, what we'll do is we'll open up my case and give it a test. Okay, it's showing up. I'm just going to quickly check it here. I have a CD I know works, Quake 3. And this CD-ROM didn't work at all. And everything else looks like it's in good shape, belt-wise and everything else. So, let's just see what happens here. This was out of a machine that was a smoker-owned, as you can see. It was worth just simply all you have to do is take a little bit of cleaner and wipe the lens down. And if it doesn't work after that, then it's never going to work. But this one was totally dead. And it's nothing wrong with it. Hope that helps you guys, because now I'm going to throw that in that tower that I just made a video of, the Dell. I'm going to throw it in that one.
Yeah.